question is regarding the research and its direction that is generally applied. So my question would be, because research, all of the higher educational institutions are responsible for the most of the leading researchers of the country, and there are many factors that influence this that get people's attention to fund the research or get businessmen to invest in an idea. So how do you think the path for, what would be the ideal way to decide that, okay, research in this field is required, so this much amount should be spent on this particular field. So what would deciding these criteria depend on? So that's my question. Thank you, sir.
Let me take you back 6 decades. When we started as a young nation wanting to make great progress, we took some extraordinary steps, very forward-looking steps. We established institutes of scientific research which were able to garner the most talented in areas of different sciences. And we gave them, according to our capacity of those days, laboratory facilities, etc., etc. My thinking is that we made one fundamental mistake. We separated research from teaching. You see, the two are not separable. Our caste system, which is pervasive, and it is pervasive in universities also. Now I give you a different scenario and think about it. There is a young person who's finished school, is very bright, very imaginative, wants to be a scientist, enrolls as a first year student in some college or university, and is being taught by the present day equivalent of a great scientist. What happens? It is a question of a spark flying. The great scientist might be able to fire that spark, which will be received by the budding scientist. Now, you leave him to routine textbook learning, that's a different matter. So we made that mistake. We did not allow teaching to be combined with research. Maybe it was an economical formula, I don't know. Somebody can educate me on this, but at this point of time, I think it was a fundamental mistake. Teaching must go with research, research must go with teaching, because the flow of ideas to and fro, it's not a one-way traffic. It has to be a two-way traffic. Some of the best problems are solved by the youngest minds.
Vijayalakshmi.
Good morning, sir.
Morning.
My name is Vijaya, and my question, I'm from Mascom second year, and my question to you is, why no Indian university features in top 100 global ranking? How the Indian government invests far less than countries having best institutes is unmentioned?
Two questions in one. The second part I'll answer, because I've already answered that we are not investing enough. But there is a problem with global ranking system, which is not generally known. The global ranking system, which was developed in the West most of the time, was premised on a free flow of teaching talent. So you can be a German and yet be teaching in a university in United States. You can be a Frenchman teaching in Germany. We don't have that system. We don't allow faculty to come from outside. Why don't we allow it? The government has a good answer, that if faculty comes from outside, then our pay scales will not suffice. So we will have to introduce a second level of pay scales, also that if we give jobs to them, then what do we do about our own job seekers? So the problem is a serious one. There are no easy solutions to it. The Chinese, who have a very highly controlled society, have solved it, from what I understand. There came a time when they opened up in certain sectors. They sent thousands of students to the United States and other places for higher learning and research. And when these people came back, because unlike Indians, they do come back. Indians don't come back. When they came back, they were given different scales of pay. Now you try this in any institution in India and see what will happen. You know, the vice chancellor will be Gheraud and not allowed a glass of water. So it is a problem in our society to which I don't have ready answers. But I think some people have thought of it. Some people are implementing it. Some of the alumni use their vacations to come and teach in their parent universities. There are good examples, not too many, but some do that. It's not sufficient, it can be encouraged, it can go further. I think that will be the answer, really.